السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد: يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم، صدق الله العظيم. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: الدين النصيحة، وصدق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. My respected elders, brothers, mothers, and sisters, as we have been discussing for the past few weeks, this very beautiful statement of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, wherein he says, "Ad-deen an-nasiha," that in short, to summarize, the essence of deen and our religion is that we are sincere. Sahaba radiallahu anhum asked, O Nabi of Allah, sincere with whom? Regarding what? The Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam responded and said, to be sincere with Allah, be sincere with the Book of Allah, be sincere with the Messenger of Allah, be sincere with A'immatul Muslimin and the leaders of the believers, and be sincere with Ammatul Muslimin, the general public. So alhamdulillah, we have been discussing for the past few weeks and we covered some of these topics. Today inshallah, I'd like to focus upon A'immatul Muslimin and Ammatul Muslimin, the two categories that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned at the end. It is a reality and it is a fact that you and I, we are human beings. Those before us were human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives honor to some. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives position to some over others. And this is something that you and I must accept from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ra'isul Munafiqeen, Abdullah bin Ubay bin Sulul, his nifaq and his hypocrisy, and the reason why he went astray was prior to migration and hijrah to Madinatul Munawwara. This individual was in line or was on the verge of becoming the leader. And it so happened, it was the taqdeer and the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, along with the Muslims, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, migrated, made hijrah, and relocated to Madinatul Munawwara, as was the chosen land by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it happened that they chose and they took and they assumed Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam as their leader. Now this was something very hard to swallow for this individual. Loss of leadership, loss of fame, loss of supposed honor in his eyes. And this led to hypocrisy. This led to him creating this movement that he created and starting that movement. So the point is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given authority to some over others. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, in many places in the Quran, instructs us as believers, as those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that not only do we owe obedience to Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but there are certain other categories of individuals who are deserving of our obedience. And our obedience to them and our good treatment with them would be obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ وَلَا تُشْرِكُ بِهِ شَيْئًا. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Declare the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not associate any partners. And right thereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And treat your parents right. Treat your parents with ihsan. Ihsan is a very beautiful word. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was asked, what is ihsan? So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam responded and he said, ihsan, this quality of ihsan, is that you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you are seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you are not able to attain this, then at least bear in mind, keep in mind, be aware, let it be known that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. If a person were to be conscious of this fact, or try to develop this quality, that I am seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in my salah, how beautiful that salah of that individual would be. And if we can attain this, and at least we have this conscious mind, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching me while I am performing my salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching me while I am alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching me while I'm driving on the road. How our actions would be. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the same word and says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Treat your parents in such a manner that no matter the situation, you are on your best behavior. You are on your best behavior. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. He is watching us. But with this conscious mind, as if you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if not, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. There's another ayah of the Quran which I just quoted in the beginning. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, all those who believe, the address is to you and I. Ati'u Allah. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ati'u Rasul. And obey Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa ulil amri minkum. And those who have the upper hand and authority over you, those who are the leaders, obey them. Their obedience, your obedience to them is obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu has just taken the role of Khalifatul Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam has just passed. It's fresh in the mind of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum agree upon Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu as being Khalifatul Rasul, the successor of Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu stands on the minbar and he addresses the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, his subjects. And he says, a very short statement. He says, Amma ba'd. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations upon Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, he starts and he says, that I have been chosen, I have been appointed, you have given me this task, this responsibility of being the leader. I am not fit for this, despite the fact that I am not fit for this. This was his humbleness, of course. But he says, despite the fact that I am not fit for this, I have been given this responsibility. So long as I am upon the straight path, so long as my decisions, my words, my statements, my actions are upon the Quran and Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it would be necessary for you to obey me. And when I go astray, if I go astray, if my decisions, if my actions, if my statements, if my path is that which is not the path of Kitabullah, not the path of Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then you do not need to obey me. This is not compulsory upon you. This is not an obligation upon you anymore. So long as our leaders are upon the truth, we must obey them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide the leaders of the Muslim Ummah today. There are individuals who speak up, you know, and who try to address, who try to rectify, who try to point out. And again, this is another point, inshallah, we will mention next week. But the point here is, every single one of us, we have mistakes. Every single one of us, errors and faults. So do our leaders. So do our leaders. Now who is A'immatul Muslimin? First let's understand this. A'immatul Muslimin. Who are the leaders of the believers? Ulama, muhaddithin, the scholars of hadith, the scholars of tafsir, they've clarified, they've made this easy for us to understand. And they have said that A'imma, the word imam, loosely translates to leader, but there are two categories. There are those who have been given leadership in the dunya. A king, a president, a prime minister, a mayor, whoever the individual may be, someone who has been given the responsibility of leadership. And then there is imam and leader fi deen, and those are the ulama, the sulaha, the scholars of deen. And ulama mentioned that in this statement, a'immatul muslimin, both categories apply. Both categories apply. Now we are living in the western part of the world, we don't have a Muslim leader in that sense where that individual rules the country. However, we have many Muslim community leaders. We have an organization here. We have leaders in organization here. We have leaders within the GTA. We have leaders within Canada, Muslim leaders. They are our A'immatul Muslimin. We have ulama. We have scholars in every corner. They are our A'immatul Muslimin. And it is only befitting for us as believers, keeping in mind the statement of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, that it is a part of our deen, that we be absolutely sincere with our leaders. We be absolutely sincere. We want, we desire, we expect the best for them and from them, both. We desire and we expect the best for them and from them. Again, you and I, we are human beings, they are human beings. I will make mistakes, they will make mistakes. I will make mistakes, they will make mistakes. But the way you and I will rectify our mistakes, and the way we will point out these mistakes to our leaders, to our ulama, to our scholars, will be that way in which it is absolutely sincere, in which there is ikhlas, in which you are desiring good for this individual. You are desiring good for this individual. A man came to Ali bin Hussein radiallahu anhu. Hussein radiallahu anhu, the grandson of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. So the great Ali ibn Hussein radiallahu anhu, Ali ibn Hussein radiallahu anhu mentions that some people came to my father, Hussein radiallahu anhu, the grandson of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And they started mentioning, na'udhu billah, thumma na'udhu billah, we seek protection in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They started mentioning and saying such things regarding the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, in particular Abu Bakr, Umar, and Uthman radiallahu anhum. That is not befitting. So they started saying things, and they started going into depth. So Hussein radiallahu anhu could no longer stand it. And he asked them, and he says, you individuals who are sitting in front of me, you must be from the category where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, للفقراء المهاجرين الذين أخرجوا, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes and mentions the qualities of the muhajirun, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum who migrated from Makkah al-Mukarramah to Madinah al-Munawwarah. He said, you must be from amongst them. They said, no, we're not. So then Hussein radiallahu anhu said, then you must be from والذين تبوؤوا الدار والإيمان من قبلهم. The next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions regarding the Ansar, those Sahaba radiallahu anhum who were inhabitants of Madinah al-Munawwarah, who assisted their brothers of Makkah, the muhajirun, when they came. They said, no, we're not from amongst them either. Then Hussein radiallahu anhu said, that be fearful, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be careful. I give witness, I am giving testimony, shahada, that you are not from amongst the first category, you are not from amongst the second category, and there is only one third category left, and I don't see you from amongst them either. That third category, وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِن بَعْدِهِمْ, those who come after the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, those who come after the Muhajirun and Ansar, their quality is such that they seek forgiveness for those who came before them. They praise them, they speak good about them. Again, like I said, you and I have faults. I have faults, you have faults. Our leaders also have faults. They are also human beings. They are also insan. Our ulama may have faults. They also make mistakes. This is a reality. That is how, that is why they are insan. Otherwise, they wouldn't be human beings. But our approach with them, and inshallah we will discuss this next week, how we are instructed from the Kitabullah and Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when you see a person who is going away from Kitabullah, when you see an individual who is going away from Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you see an individual who is going away from the ijma' of the ummah, then how you and I can approach this individual or these situations, and how our behavior should be towards them. Again, I quote the hadith of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, deen in essence, in summary, in short, is that we are absolutely sincere. Sahaba radiallahu anhum asked, O Nabi of Allah, sincerity with whom? Sincere regarding whom? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned, be sincere with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be sincere with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be sincere with the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And be sincere with the leaders of the Muslims. Be sincere with the general public. Inshallah, we will elaborate a little bit more about this in the coming weeks. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be sincere individuals. Jazakumullah wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah alladhi ahsana khalqa al-insani wa adala. وأفاض على قلبه خزائن العلوم فأكمله ثم أمده بلسان يترجم به عما حواه القلب وعقله ويكشف عنه ستره الذي أرسله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله الذي أكرمه وبجله ونبيه الذي أرسله بكتاب أنزله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ما كبر الله عبد وهلل أما بعد فإن اللسان جرمه صغير وجرمه كبير فلذلك مدح الشرع الصمت وحث عليه إلا بالحق فقال عليه الصلاة والسلام من يضمن لي ما بين لحيه وما بين رجليه أضمن له الجنة وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام سباب المسلم فسوق وقتاله كفر وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام لا يدخل الجنة قتات وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام إن الصدق بر وإن البر يهدي إلى الجنة وإن الكذب فجور وإن الفجور يهدي إلى النار وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام أتدرون ما الغيبة قالوا الله ورسوله أعلم قال ذكرك أخاك بما يكره قيل أفرأيت إن كان في أخي ما أقول قال إن كان فيه ما تقول فقد اغتبت وإن لم يكن فيه ما تقول فقد بهدت وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام من صمت نجا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا كثيرًا أما بعد فيا أيها الناس أوصيكم ونفسي أولًا بتقوى الله والمواظبة على ذكر الله ألا خير الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي صلاة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة واعلموا أن الله أمركم بأمر عظيم فبدأ بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه وثلث بكم أيها المؤمنون فقال تبارك وتعالى مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين خصوصا على الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعلى سائر الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر من نصر الإسلام والمسلمين واجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل الإسلام والمسلمين ولا تجعلنا منهم ولا معهم عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله تعالى يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
سووا صفوفكم فإن تسوية الصفوف من تمام الصلاة Please make sure lines are straight, no gaps in between and please turn your phones off to silent. جزاكم الله الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية؟ وجوه يومئذ خاشعة، عاملة ناصبة، تصلى نارا حامية، تسقى من عين آنية، ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع، وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية، في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية، فيها عين جارية، فيها سرر مرفوعة، وأكواب موضوعة، ونمارق مصفوفة، وزرابي مبثوثة. أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت، وإلى السماء كيف رفعت، وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت، وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت. فذكر إنما أنت مذكر، لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر، فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر، إن إلينا إيابهم، ثم إن علينا حسابهم.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.